Good job. and I mean, it's actually becoming a man who helps us in so many ways. It's been a big blessing, really, and I appreciate it very much. And he's an excellent member of our local church here. And likewise, he was raised up here. I've been his pastor since he was four. And he was our youth pastor. And when he works for me a long time, they have to be down over 32 years. And I've been trying to tell this pulpit, just get the water somewhere where I'm not trying to preach for 32 years. And so, I feel home in the day. And I don't care if you're home. Tell your neighbor, say, what's this home? Amen. Do not accept late work. Paul was saying, do not accept the number 12 and verse number 8. The Father can work in that great service, go to sewer, and all the good things you use that planning, and God bless you. For I can all tell you that Deuteronomy, and this is what it says, he shall not do after all the things that we do here this day, every man whatsoever is right in his own eyes. And notice what he said. You shall not do after all the things that we do here this day, every man whatsoever is right in his own eyes. In the book of Judges, chapter 17, verse 6, said, in those days, there was no king in Israel, but every man did that which is right in his own eyes. Then in chapter 21:25, saying, take those right, some verses repeated. Chapter 21:25, that says, there was no king in Israel, but every man did what was right in his own eyes, that which was right in his own eyes. So today, I want to talk to you from these verses, and I'll be through in about 5 minutes. Thank you for your word. We thank you for this wonderful opportunity to hear your word preached from this man of God. We ask you to open our minds and our hearts. Talk to everyone this morning. I pray that every youth leader, every young person would leave this service changed in Jesus' name. We thank you for it by faith and everybody to you. Amen. We pray. Amen. God said, he immediately began to come back to worship God. I mean, he said, God does not remember the day you went down, he'll be alive, and he'll be his God, so I'm going to leave him. He turned around and got a pretty picture, and he fell for it, and she forgot that the forbidden fruit, and forgetting for a husband, and he didn't eat and sin, any of this from himself. God had a disobedience in the garden to God. Amen. And the Bible talks about, before saying to you, how they walked with God, talked with God in the cool of the night. Well, of course, someone else appeared in that garden to break up the state of perfection. His name historically was called Lucifer. Who is he? This probably talked about Lucifer. Who is he? In Job chapter 1, that's where he did this last day. So in Job chapter 1, 22 verse 6, he said, that was a day when he sent the doctrine to present himself before the Lord, and Satan did all for hunger. But it was a day. But it was a day when he sent the doctrine to present himself to God, but Satan did not want any large of him. But Satan, where's that was now? Where'd you come from? Then Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro, and the earth, and from walking up and down in it. Where'd you come from? All of this, walking around, this here and there. Peter, First Peter tells us that Satan is going about as a roaring lion. He is not a roaring lion, but he goes about as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. So, Satan came to Lucifer to destroy the peace. And the blessing of the tranquility and the love that was in that garden. He came to disrupt the fellowship with God. Satan is called Lucifer, he's called Satan, he's called the devil, he's called the wicked one, he's called the prince of the power of the air, he's called the spirit that now works in the children of disobedience. Satan is called a lot of things. But I tell you that he's not so afraid. And I want to tell you something else. A lot of people get to do a lot of credit, but they're going to have good people. They're not smart. They're not practical. I want to tell you, he's God. Praise God. I want to tell you something else. He doesn't have any plan for your life whatsoever. He has no plan like that for your life for future. Amen. Amen. He said, the devil, he'll say he's smart, I'll help you, but he has absolutely no plan for your life. He is promised. He has no plan for your life. Let's look at Isaiah 13, verse 12, for a moment. I don't want to worry about the meeting that I go over, but the Romans 14 and verse 12 talks a little about Lucifer. How about falling from heaven, Lucifer, son of the morning, how to cut down the ground and stay as sweet as the incarnation in verse 13. And I say in my heart, I have no say of this. Notice what the goal said. Notice the personal pronouns I. He said, I was in heaven. I want to talk my throne about the stars of God. I was set upon the mountains of the stars of God. Verse 14, I will set about that. The lights of God, I will do it to God. Notice over and over, he said, I. Amen. The devil is all caught up in his own desire, in his own plan, and his own purpose. But he himself doesn't. Thank you. said, I'm going to go to I will be out full time. Of course, when he said, I'll be out full time, God said, no, I said, oh, so there's no light we run beside me. There's not another God, but there's nobody else in front of the story. But he can come to himself above God and try to become people with God. The God said, my glory will not give up to another. So, Lucifer, when he said, I'll be out full time, he was cast out of heaven. Through rebellion, by a rebellion, he was cast out of heaven. He started insurrection in heaven. He's only rebellion among the angels. And God began to laugh. For the time that God began to laugh, rebellion was never over. God was not going to rebellion to pull out of the way to heaven. However, God began to do rebellion to reach into heaven. God wanted to the church. And God went to the youth group. God will never bless rebellion. God will never honor a bad spirit. Hallelujah. You say, well, I'm glad from doing my answer. Well, my God, that's what we call the altar here for. That's going through and get right with God. It's not fun. But if you praise well, and so the people did not succeed in his rebellion. God defeated Lucifer, and so Satan and his angels were cast out of heaven, they were cast out to the earth, and now then, the earth is the headquarters of Satan. I want you to know that up until this time, when God made everything, it's in his blood, there's nothing to say that, but remember, but God made the heaven. Hell was prepared later, but God made the world and everything therein. He did not make the hell. What do you need to? Later on, Matthew 25:41, in the hell was prepared for the devil and his angels. Are you still with me? Amen. But God did everything perfect. There was no hell. But when sin came, when disobedience came, the thing that God did came, when the anarchy came, and Satan and a fallen angel were cast out with him, and man had somewhere to go. Praise God. And hell was prepared for the devil and his angels. Hell wasn't prepared for you. So if you go to hell, you're going as an intruder. God don't want you there. You don't want to go there. Things are headed that direction. You can't turn around to hell. Somebody shout amen. God will tell every person in this world to be saved. God will tell everybody in this community to heaven. It's not his will that aims to perish, but for all that come will perish. But Satan was cast out. And the man was Michael and Gabriel and Lucifer. They came to be the leaders of the archangels. They all had other angels walked under them in rank and so on. And when Lucifer was cast out, one part of the angels were cast out with him, and his hell was prepared for the devil. Now, let me say this. If you lost his life, he should have hell had been marked for sin. That's all that went first. It's the devil and his angels. But now, when Adam sinned, and when he ever sat down, as did sin, and the devil won't be human family, then the Bible said hell had been marked for sin. Because it was personally made for Lucifer and the angels. He asked him here.
Taking care of it, he has no plan, he has no plan.
own purpose. He has nothing to lay out. And he said, this is what I want to do. Jesus don't care. That's it. He hates God, not nobody else. Amen. He hates God because God took dominion over him and authority over him and cast him out of heaven. And he didn't like it. And he's been mad at it ever since. And he's got one desire. He's got to just please God and find his God. And the day that I'm going to find his God is finally striking at God's creation. You know, the best way to get that money to God is to get through you and me. Amen. We have God's creation. We have God's representatives. We have God's ambassadors. So Satan says, if I can stop the church, then I defeat God. If I can stop the church, I'll stop God's purpose. Hallelujah. I'm going to tell you, he couldn't stop God, but he can't stop the church because God is in the midst of his people. This is not just another building on the street and the new church. This is not just another building on the street. This is the church. This is the ecclesia. This is the town outlines. This is the body of Christ. The Spirit of God is in us. And the devil cannot defeat us. It's not God. It's in us. And it's not before us. Thank you. position to apply for a permanent position. Not temporary. Not just for the Lord. I'm not going to be sure of you, but I have all the thoughts in me that if you're not application for a permanent position as a worship, as a bishop, that worship God must worship Him in spirit and in true knowledge, for the Father sees us.
Just a little bit of time.
Larry and said, I was born there recently, and he told me, so I was ready, but he said, I said, I don't think you live ever did not swing it. And so my friend, Feinstein, he said, you think you can live one day without swinging it? I said, well, I don't think I could. But he said, well, do you think you can live 1 hour without swinging? And then we went to the ex-offic and we did that. He said, well, then, my suggestion to you is that you make God an hour in time. If you wait 1 hour and not praise the devil, but praise God with life, I say to you, come get a third hour, and then I'll walk out. And the fifth hour, you can make it by month, make it by week, you can make it by week, make it by hour, you can make it by hour, and if an hour can win it, but all day, it's an hour.
Thank you.
that's what happened. And I was saying, and what the hell? I'm trying to save him. My God, I'm trying to hit him. But I'm not even trying to hit him. I'm trying to hit him. He
Thank you.
principles. It's a principle. It's a principle of faith in Jesus. Don't let me teach you. It's a principle of Holy Ghost being in God. It's a principle of Jesus. We talk to second person of the Triune God, but He's mighty God. But the devil says, don't go there. Now, by the way, I've helped people live by Him, and others have been able to believe. They go there, what's He believe? A lot of you preachers have no answer. And many people come to this church. I've been 42 years to come to Sunday. But I'm going to start with my wife and my two girls who were in this 2006. That was my total God the first Sunday. But he's 42 years ago. And I'm still happy, Pastor. I served up my wife, served up both kids, and I asked this week, but my fifth grand child. Hallelujah. I praise my baby in Houston before I'm on the day. Well, that's what you say. I pray so, bless God. I said, I'm going to listen to the drums and the song, and the things that I think I'm doing, I like to listen to the suggestions. So, I want to pass the music. And you know what I mean? I went to the hospital, put in a chair, and I'm all pushed with my little dog arm, and the arm told me, I put my father in the house, and I'll help you stop that pop out of the time. I can't believe it's time. But I got five grandchildren. Hallelujah. I don't want any boys except four. And so I'm happy. Praise God. I said, I'm happy. I'm just as happy as all the rest of this God. Never had a happy day in this hell, no. But I'm happy. Praise God. If you want, I've been here for 32 years Sunday. And I see people come to this church. I've been into one church. And I don't get no trouble. They come to the church. They never go. And I can still come here. He was here Tuesday night. And I was here. I went to the Mormons. I went to the Jehovah's Witnesses. I went to Catholics. I tried this and that. You know what? But she said, nobody's there. And look, I'm going to get out of trouble. And when she came to me, she said, I got that time for one of them. She said, oh, that don't go through. I don't know what the devil said. I don't care what he wants. I don't tell him anything. I don't keep back. I three, I five, I ten, I 20. I don't tell him anything. God is. He's the one who teaches us. He's the one I have. He's the one I have. He's the one I have. What's the problem? Thank you. was like that. I said, you don't want to be like that. You don't want to be like that. You don't want to get through with hell. Don't say, well, God, you didn't make it. He's playing God over this manifestation. He only put that on Almighty God. So I like that title. That is a phrase. So the devil may not be trying to get you to go to hell. He just don't want you to go to heaven. And be praying to me. So you know what? What you can do, you'll worship the God that he hates. You'll praise the God he hates. And he has a fear that we put toward God. Hallelujah. The old trouble of the little black to the house is one child and their child. So I put the tongues on the back of him and the word of God. Shake them hands. No plan for your life. He says, it's your job. You're going to get him. And it's all right. He wants you on truth. He is. But don't serve God. Anything you want to. The devil did not prepare it all for you. This is the true holy witness. The devil did not prepare it all for you. God prepared the devil. But the devil has no mind. Amen. Hallelujah. The devil is the author of the so-called freedom in America. Freedom to take down abortion. Freedom to begin to watch that. Freedom by looking at pornography. Freedom to watch all the pills that the government gets. And for your national comedy. And for movies and so on. Well, that's your movie. Hallelujah. They don't care what you like, just don't follow God. That's why they don't care if you go to the church of the cross. You hear me? When you had called me here a while back, when he said, as I saw, he said, does the church have a front door for you? I said, well, sir. He said, could you tell me a church of theirs? I don't have a church. He's got a front door for you. I said, you know, I really don't know what more who has it. It was telling you not to sit around saying, I said, well, was it Jesus coming here and being for me? He said, well, look at the church that's a boy. I said, we stand in the folds and place the Lord to his heart. He said, I'm looking for the church that's a boy. I said, we preach the gospel, we preach the very God, that's what's happening. He said, oh, this is my church, that's a football team. I said, well, listen, we're going to have words, all right? If you want to try and run the ball, I said, the best way you can do this. You know, Jesus, you know, you better say my words, you know, praise God, praise God. But you know what? The church has something to offer you. There's some churches today that can offer you a lot of things. But the true church can offer you peace. Can offer you joy. Can offer you happiness. Can offer you the blessing of God. Can offer you life eternal. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Some people say, I'm going to the church of my choice. When you say your God's choice, they're almost going to figure out me. Not be God's choice. Because the flesh is in the deep, deep spot. Your flesh will not bring forth guilt. And you will not start to get in the spirit and walk into God's purpose and God's plan. Hallelujah. Say, God, whatever you need to do, that's what I'm going to do. Say to God, full of force. Exactly what you want to do. He said, you know what you did at the church over there? I said, what we did? He had a little muscle. I said, since I've been there, you have a great temple. You have a place in heaven. I'm going to get this church. Don't tell us more about what we are. They all know. They all know. There's a couple of questions. Just want to hear everyone take that service and go play the ball and go play couch for either. When you have the word of God, what do you know about it? Well, I've heard. Believe God, don't save yourself. That's the kind of thing you say. Don't be wrong. But the devil devil. The devil comes in to say, what you doing? Where are you going? We're going to be with you. This comes in with all the possibilities we're talking about. Hallelujah. It comes in place of honor. It comes in hallelujah. Lord, does everything know? So he's going to call him again and he said, you want to do that for me? I said, hold it in the kitchen. He said, you brainwashed me. He said, you're right. He said, you're right. He said, yeah.
Thank you.
someone else's fault. I'm just kidding. You know, when people there's one thing that comes to mind for my young people, and that's the question of everything. We should do it, but there's a lot of life that you need to do. He said, what do you say? I'm trying to get you out.
I'm going to
I know. They come from against God. And they try to get other things from the Lord. Just don't say God. Takes a lot of time to remember what to say. I'm somebody who wants to know what I can't do. Just do it. I don't care what to say. But if you pin this out on the stuff right now, I know God is again in my church. Just don't leave it alone. We don't care. People suggest it's suicide. And it's so much fun. And don't tell me in that way. Do you think that's righteous and holy?
And said, no pain is allowed. They give people a thousand turns.
spitting or stomping in a prison or some little thing you call. You know what?
Thank you. The name above every other name. Jesus, the only one.